simple. And this is right with, this is now with the machine, eh?
Yeah, that's what it's
surviving motor cars in the world. It's a France. Steam boiler.
Oh, it's a steam.
So you have a hot water in it.
Yeah.
And then the lantern with the gas on it. Mm-hmm. That's for your lamp.
It takes 15 minutes to get up to speed.
The wheel, is that a metal or it's a rubber?
I think it's rubber, but they didn't have the air filled tires yet. That was actually, I think, Dunlop.
It's like only the rubber was plucked on the wood, yeah. Or what? This is more older than that. That was 1887, this is 1875.
Yeah. The first car was invented in 18.
Where are you going to sit? Please fasten your seat. There in the middle?
I don't know.
Beakers fire pump? Beakers? Bikers?
Beakers. Beakers is the name, I think.
And this is 1880 petrol driven. So it's used now petrol for it. Music wheel. To move the music.
You can see that the finger on the side, and all of it is too far.
Oh.
Looks a bit creepy.
Oh, they have now a ketting. A chain.
Cabin.
They have now a chain on it. 1894. Opel show. This is the first model of Opel show.
Yep.
Horseless carriage.
Shape as well.
From Great Britain. It's a Daimler. One of the earliest British built cars. Until 1924. Creepy.
No, another one.
It's creepy. This this is like the same from the first one there. See, identical from the other one.
Yeah.
So this is now like the bicycle. Oh, this is where the tricycle. There. More, the car is more from France, huh? The model. Hmm? We found a lot of model from France.
Yeah, well, it was the Germans who invented the cars.
I mean, the old models, it's like starting from France.
They just happen to have these.
This is the tricycle. Three-wheel bicycle.
I like the one on the back.
Oh, you're facing each other?
I just like the color and the way it looks.
So where's the driver?
Well, that thing in the middle there with that handle, that is apparently the steering wheel.
Yeah.
So the driver will be sitting there.
For two person?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I like it because also look at the brass on there, it's really nice.
1899, a real family car. So you have a father and a mother and the two children. This one.
This looks like a quad.
It's like a motor.
Yeah.
Let's say the. How do you call now the bicycle with the buck fits? Quadricycle. Four wheels.
You've got easy access to the engine.
So it's all France model.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that is the one with the family car.
Another horseless carriage.
The first four cylinder in history.
Nice color again.
Yeah, maroon is nice color. 1895.
Is that the price?
In America.
Ah, it's American.
Says horsepower. So there's an engine on it. Yeah, because there's a kettle on it.
I always find it fascinating how these people. How people in general manage to figure out stuff like this, you know? I mean, we all take it for granted. But somebody thought up this, you know?
Actually, old generation are more smart because they don't have any base when they design it.
That's what I mean.
So, the new generation, they have already from the old model, they just modify it. What is worst?
Well, apparently that's what it's called. They produced 15 cars, and this is one of the two of which they know they survived.
So they bring it here in Netherlands?
Yeah.
They did not put it in their museum there.
Yeah,
yeah.
They've had it in storage since. And since the 40s, and they took it out in 1981.
1901, the rocks, France again. Nice design, no?
This is nice. Careful, a nice photo of this one.
Here, as you stand here.
Yeah, this is okay.
Belgium, Victoria. The horn, toot toot.
Did you read this?
Yeah.
Quite funny. Apparently there was the largest car builder in 1904, and the owner of the car company didn't like to drive, he couldn't drive, and he lost interest and started to, I don't know, with a casino.
Supplied new in the Netherlands.
Oh, it's got a nice little Hong Kong.
Hong Kong? And the passenger is at the back, seeing nothing at all. And a nice motor, Eric.
Yeah, motorbikes don't interest me that much, though. That's strange, you just mentioned it there. See that lever there?
Yeah.
The crank. That's how you start the engine.
Oh, so you have to turn first? Mm-hmm. Okay.
But normally it's at the front. This one. Oh, look, nice copper detail there.
Yeah, for the ketting.
Beautiful.
Another front car. The finest car of its day. Side of the front, the coat of arms of the family. Ah, there. The coat of the that owned this car still be seen on the side of the front. Yeah. Side of the front seat. The coat. U.S. made by the inventor of the stapler. He went to America.
Apparently the inventor of the stapler made this.
Hmm. This is the sunbeam of the motor, sociable. Small engine here.
Mm-hmm.
It's a three-wheeler.
Yeah, there's something about the English and their love for three-wheeled cars. Remember Del Boy and his three-wheeled van?
Yeah.
Not a good idea because they're very unstable. You take a bend too fast, you're on your side. Well, I'm supposing that this thing didn't go so fast, so it wouldn't be a problem.
I don't like the way you drive. Singer tricycle.
Singer?
Yeah.
Sewing machines?
Yeah, I think the same. The same, I think, a founder or manufacturer. Oh, developer.
This one's nice.
This one is the Singer tricycle.
I see the engine they mounted in the front wheel.
Yeah.
That's different.
And this one.
Oh, this is another mobile. Oldsmobile.
I hear a lot of the music. There will be a copyright with this.
Copyright?
Yeah, when you put in your video with the music, it will be copyright.
Put it on Rumble.
Look at this, it's video editor can remove the music. World's first mass produced automobile.
Nice
US curb dash, for obvious reason. 1901. So old. The leather, huh? Still okay.
Yeah, I'm quite amazed at the state of these. A lot of them are not even being restored.
Yeah.
This again, not restored.
Well, it looks nice, huh? Mm-hmm.
1908.
My grandfather is already born, 1907.
This looks French for some reason, but I don't know. It could also be British.
Oh, this is like military car.
It's German.
Looks like military car.
Yeah.
Where is the back? Well, pass to at the back. Oh, this is like the starting of the steering wheel. Okay, guess.
Looks like a shovel. They produced this for 20 years.
Yeah? German car.
Yeah, they made loads of them, apparently. Oh, here's a car that looks like a car.
Oh, it's an experimental vehicle. This one now is the start of the car.
This one looks really like a car. Regal Model N Roadster.
It's only the driver have on a glass in front to protect his face.
1910.
There's no woman driving car before in the old time.
Not in that period, no.
So they have a glass there in the driving seat, driver's seat.
So apparently you could switch bodies on these cars.
Interchangeable bodies. What do you mean bodies?
So you can change the whole look of the car, apparently.
So you can have a left side driver or right side driver?
I don't know. I think it's about the fenders and stuff like that. You just, you know, you can interchange them. It's a nice car, though.
Now he wouldn't be here. This looks like the original Daimler.
Men's.
Yeah.
Dutch. German. 1886. Mm-hmm. The first patented motor. So. How do you feel driving with nothing in front of me?
It didn't go that fast. So, no need for airbags and crap like that.
It's like you are driving, like sitting in the Ferris wheel.
I like all the stuff.
English car. British belt bands. This one also. Stone Ferrari. Chemis Vasserei. In German, oldest motorized van in the world. So this is the van. You deliver stuff on it.
Looks it, yeah.
The most luxurious model Benz. Dr. In Carl Benz. Is that a connection with Mercedes-Benz?
Yeah.
Dr. In Carl Benz.
At first they were called Daimler Benz. Because they could leave Daimler and Carl Benz, they started the factory. That was their first, from Carl Benz.
Mm-mm. Automobile Club of Great Britain.
Yesterday I watched a program on it, remember, on YouTube.
Yeah.
Daimler became known in England. They built cars there. Mm-mm. And in Germany they started with the Mercedes Benz.
Mm. So these are all Benz wagon. Yeah.
So they probably all run.
Oh yeah, because it's all German. Only that one is a British.
I like this one. Nice green detail there.
That's only the British one. 1899. Traditional model.
Mm-hmm. 1899.
So this is now where you press the action.
Yeah.
So you have gas, brake.
And the clutch.
And for the clutch.
And everything's very accessible, and I'm assuming that's because if it breaks down frequently, you can at least fix it easily.
Same here. But it's only two. And it.
See the exhaust is this.
The sole survivor. Doc Victoria. And this one is the brake. Handbrake, maybe.
This is the handbrake, yeah.
Yeah, that's why it's only two left there. is speak. $18.95 Ben's Python through horseless carriage. Six people. Two cylinder luxury, my Lord Victorian.